Today we are covering HyImpulse, one of several commercial launch companies from Germany. We'll cover the technology, launch vehicle and the important milestones achieved so far, and finish with upcoming events for this exciting space startup. Let's get started with an introduction to HyImpulse. HyImpulse states their mission is to revolutionize access to space by making it both affordable and environmentally sustainable. They aim to reduce the current high cost of getting to orbit and reduce the long waiting times. They use efficient paraffin-powered engines. We'll talk more about their engines later. Paraffin, commonly referred to as candle wax, is safe, cheap, and readily available. HyImpulse estimates that costs can be reduced by a remarkable 40% by using paraffin instead of a liquid fuel, as many other launch companies do. HyImpulse's order books exceed 100 million euros, signaling strong market confidence in the company. Their order books grow monthly, showing demand for rocket launchers, especially by European customers. Next, let's examine the technology HyImpulse is using in their launch vehicle. The HyImpulse small satellite launcher is powered by an innovative hybrid engine running on a paraffin-based fuel. Paraffin fuels are safer to operate, more efficient, and have a lower environmental impact compared to kerosene propellants. They also pose no explosion risk. Why did HyImpulse choose hybrid propulsion? HyImpulse chose hybrid propulsion for their rockets because it offers a balance between the advantages of liquid and solid propellants. Specifically, it combines the benefits of liquid propellants, such as the ability to throttle, shut down and restart the engines, with the simplicity and lower cost of solid propulsion systems. One key advantage of using paraffin as a fuel is its safety and ease of handling, which is superior to other common solid propellants. By using paraffin, HyImpulse can eliminate half of the plumbing required for fuel delivery, including valves, pumps, and other components. This simplification leads to reduced complexity and lower costs. The combination of liquid oxygen and paraffin as propellants provides an ISP, that is specific impulse, that is nearly as high as a combination of liquid oxygen and RP1, a common rocket fuel used by other rockets like the Falcon 9. ISP is a measure of the efficiency of a rocket engine, representing the amount of thrust produced per unit of fuel. In rocketry, a higher ISP is desirable as it means more thrust is generated from the same amount of fuel. Next, let's examine the orbital launcher from HyImpulse. SL1, the orbital launcher. The HyImpulse orbital launch vehicle provides both dedicated and ride-shared missions. Let's go over some of the technical details first. Payload to LEO, 600 kilos, that's 1,322 pounds. Total length, 33 meters, 108 feet. Diameter, 2.2 meters, or 7.2 feet. Propulsion, LOX, that's liquid oxygen, and paraffin, and three stages. The third stage is a kick stage for precise deployment to multiple orbital planes or inclinations. The HyImpulse S1 launcher features a unique propulsion system with 12 hybrid rocket engines and a new turbo pump system for liquid oxygen. This setup enhances the performance of the engines to a level suitable for commercial applications. HyImpulse faces competition from both local and international players in the small satellite launch market. While their payload capacity is smaller compared to competitors like ISAR Aerospace and Orbex, being a European company gives them an advantage over American rivals such as SpaceX with European customers. SpaceX's transporter missions are limited to sun-synchronous orbits, which might not be suitable for all satellite payloads. In response, SpaceX has introduced bandwagon rideshare missions to mid-inclination orbits, potentially affecting the market for small satellite launchers. To remain competitive, HyImpulse must offer competitive pricing and flexibility in launch timing. Let's briefly go over some of the most important milestones for HyImpulse so far. September 2022 launch services agreement with DCUBED. HyImpulse signs a launch agreement with the German new space company Deployables Cubed GmbH, or DCUBED. The payload will launch on the maiden flight of SL1, which is currently scheduled for the second half of 2025. It will be an in-space manufacturing technology demonstrator. DCUBED sees in-space manufacturing as a technology to enable more advanced mission concepts. In-space manufacturing can reduce complexity of current deployment mechanisms, which may require many folded parts that need to be unfurled and pinned into place. All of these mechanisms need to survive the launch vibrations and acoustic environment. In the technology demonstrator flying on HyImpulse, a long linear boom made out of photopolymer will be extruded and cured. If successful, this will prove that booms can be manufactured in space. A photopolymer is a resin that is liquid in its initial state. The demonstrator will dispense the resin through a nozzle that defines the tube shape of the boom. Directly after the nozzle, ultraviolet light cures the resin to solidify the tube. A payload is attached to the nozzle from the beginning, and therefore the continuous printing process also serves to deploy the payload. In-space manufacturing for external satellite structures will be one of the building blocks for the future of the space economy. The technology enables highly scalable and large structures within a high packaging efficiency. While today comparable elements are often folded or deployed, causing severe limitations, in-space manufacturing offers a solution to resolve these problems. This demonstration is a major step forward to bring it to reality, says Michael Kringer, in-space manufacturing lead at DCUBED. Dr. Thomas Sin, the CEO and founder of DCUBED, said, "I cannot wait to bring the in-space manufacturing experiment into space. I'm excited to launch it on the maiden flight of HyImpulse's orbital vehicle." In February 2023, there was a successful burst test of the liquid oxygen tank. This successful test marks a key milestone in the development of HyImpulse's orbital small launcher, SL1. The hydrostatic burst test is a critical step in the development of any pressure vessel and is used to ensure the safety and reliability of the tank under extreme conditions. The test subjects the tank to pressures far beyond what is expected to experience in normal operation to identify any potential weaknesses or failure points. LOX tank passed the test with flying colors, demonstrating its ability to withstand pressures well beyond the limits of its intended use. In September 2023, HyImpulse's rocket motor engine is qualified. HyImpulse passes a key milestone with the official qualification of their flight motor. This inches them closer to a full suborbital flight next year. In November 2023, HyImpulse is in talks with SaxaVord to launch from their spaceport in Scotland. HyImpulse has been talking with SaxaVord since 2021. They have already done flight motor testing in Scotland. Co-CEO Christian Schirmer says, "We are looking forward to working with SaxaVord and expanding our operation in the UK for the work on propulsion development and testing, rocket structures and ground infrastructure in the coming months." SaxaVord said they are happy to continue supporting HyImpulse towards their orbital launches. SaxaVord recently acquired a spaceport license from the Civil Aviation Authority in the UK. This makes SaxaVord the first vertical launch facility to be granted the right to launch rockets from the UK. Rocket Factory Augsburg will also be launching from SaxaVord, along with Orbex and ABL. In May 2024, test launch of SR-75, a 12-metre, 2.5-tonne single-stage rocket. In Cuniba, Australia, an Australian launch site, HyImpulse successfully launched their SR-75, which can send 250 kilos of payload to an altitude of 250 kilometres well into space. The launcher will be retrieved for examination and analysis. Dr. Mario Cobalt, co-founder and CEO of HyImpulse, said, "Setting up a commercial launch vehicle equipped with entirely new propulsion technology up for launch and liftoff with such an efficient team and a relatively small budget is quite a feat. We're signalling Germany's prowess as a spacefaring nation and expanding Europe's access to space. Already we're planning the launch of a larger, multi-stage transport launch vehicle capable of deploying satellites weighing up to 600 kilos into low Earth orbits by the end of next year." Okay, let's look at upcoming events to look forward to. The initial launch of the orbital launch vehicle is scheduled for the end of 2025. We can't wait to see this hybrid launcher take to the skies. We'll be covering the launch and all the important events leading to the launch on this channel. Be sure to subscribe to get the latest news on commercial space startups around the globe. From rocket launches to space stations, orbital tugs, lunar landers and more. If it's a commercial space startup, we cover it. See you soon.